How many times have you gone back to an app you haven't used in a while and you're presented with this? I don't remember which authentication method I used, it was so long ago the cookies expired. And that's where this super awesome UX pattern comes into play. This is from a tweet put out by Danny Postma showing a convenient little label for the most recently used authentication method. This was surfaced through my feed by Guillermo from Vercel, who used V0 to recreate this interface. So that's exactly where I started. If you've never used V0 before, it looks like this, and it allows you to input a text prompt like a login page that has options for email and password, GitHub, and Google. You could also give it an image, which is actually how I generated this initially, by just taking a screenshot of Guillermo's UI and dumping it into V0. You can also choose a different color scheme if you'd like. Let's go with midnight so we get some form of dark mode, and click submit, and you'll see this is streaming in options for all of those different bits that we asked for, giving us a mock-up of what we asked for. Looks like it's messed up the logo there for GitHub, but we'll ignore that. But we also get multiple options. So we've got A, B, and C, which are all slight variations on the same idea. I quite like this first one, so we can have a look at the awesomely generated, quite high quality React code that also uses Tailwind for all of the styles and ShadCN for any of these React components. If we wanted to change anything, we've also got this text prompt to have a conversation back and forth with the AI model. So we could say, also add a sign up button, and we'll see we get a new version of our UI, and that's going to stream in those changes. And we can see we now have our sign in, sign up, and then each of our OAuth providers for GitHub and Google. So next up, I created a Next.js project using the Supabase template. So this configures all the cookie-based auth stuff, so you don't need to think about it, and you can get up and running with a single command. Also, there's a video I'll link to at the end of this one that shows you the fastest possible way to get up and running with Next.js and Supabase. So this is my login page in my Next.js application. Users can either authenticate with email and password, or using OAuth with GitHub or Google. If we click one of these buttons, so let's sign in with Google, it's going to ask which account we'd like to use. I'm just going to use my personal one, but don't email me because I probably won't email back. And when that authentication flow has completed, we land on this protected page because we're now an authenticated user. So then let's say a couple of months go by. We've been using this application happily, but now we come back to the app and we see this screen. Damn, did I use email and password or did I use OAuth? And if I use the wrong one, is it going to create a new account or is it going to know to merge these? These are the questions we don't want our users to have to ask. So let's add a nice little hint next to this sign in button to say this was the last one that you used. So if we have a look at our code, we can see that each one of these authentication strategies is a separate form, and each one of those forms submits to a different server action. So if we have a look at this one for sign in with email, it's pretty clear if we just read through line by line. Use server means run this chunk of code on the server rather than the client. We're then getting that email and password field from our form, and then creating a Supabase client, which we use to call supabase.auth.signinwithpassword, passing across that email and password. Now, if we get back an error from trying to authenticate with that email and password, then we're redirecting to basically just show an error on the page. And then if there isn't an error, then everything was all good with the authentication. So we redirect to this protected page that we only want the user to see if they have successfully authenticated. And we've got a nice little to-do here to say this is probably where we want to set our last signed in method to email. Now we've actually already got this variable in our code declared above, so this is just set to null at the moment. But if we set this to the string email and go back to the browser, we'll see our nice little label saying that this was the last used authentication method. And so the code for that one looks something like this, where if the last signed in method is equal to the string email, then we want to show our overly complicated element displaying that last used text. And we have this check duplicated for GitHub. That's just TypeScript letting us know that this can never happen because we're setting it to the static value of email. And then we also have this conditionally rendering label element for if the last sign in method was Google. So we can check each of these states work by setting our last signed in method to GitHub and giving this a save, going back to the browser, and then we see that label over the GitHub button. And just in case you really don't trust me, if we set this to Google and save, we see that label jumps down to Google. So how do we remember which one of these was used the last time the user signed in? Well, we can save that value in a cookie. So a cookie gets sent along with every request and is available across the client and server side. And if we dig into our create client function that we're using to create a Supabase client, we can see cookies is exactly how we save that authentication state. So let's bake ourselves a delicious cookie. So back over in our login page, we want to get a list of all of our cookies by calling the cookies function. So this one comes in from next/headers. And when we call that function, we get back a list of cookies, or more appropriately, a cookie jar, which we can use to put cookies in and take cookies out. So let's start by checking if there's a cookie in the cookie jar that contains our last sign-in method. So we can say cookie jar.get and then give it the name of our cookie. So this can be last sign-in method. So this will give us back the actual cookie. So then if we have a cookie called last sign-in method, then we want to grab its value and then store that in our last sign-in method variable. So we can get rid of this one here. So we're reading the value of that cookie if it exists in the cookie jar before we actually render our page to determine whether we want to render any of those hints. So let's write that sign-in method to the cookie every time we successfully authenticate. So over in our server action for sign-in with email, after we've made sure that there isn't an error, we want to create an instance of our cookie jar by calling the cookies function and then use the cookie jar to set a new cookie with the name last signed in method. And in this case, we've successfully authenticated with email, so we want to set the cookie value to the string email. Now we can copy and paste these two lines into each of our server actions after we've determined that there isn't an error and we are successfully authenticated. So for this one, we used GitHub, and then after authenticating with Google, we want to set that cookie value to Google. Now, when we go back to the browser, we don't see any of our hints because we haven't actually set that cookie. But now if we authenticate with GitHub, we see this protected page because we're authenticated. But now if we log out, we don't actually see that hint. But that's because I made a typo where the cookie we're setting is called last signed in method. And when we're reading it at the top, we're reading last sign in method. So we want this to be sign in method. Now, if we save this and go back to our application, we see that hint that GitHub was the last authentication method used. And if we do something else like sign in with email and password, we see our protected page. And when we log out, we'll see our authentication method has been updated to email and password. If you want to build something like this yourself or anything using Next.js and Supabase, then check out this video right here. We use the Supabase template to create a new Next.js project, getting all that authentication and cookies config out of the way so you can focus on the most important bit, which is also usually my closing catchphrase, so keep building cool stuff.